Hello, dear teacher trainees, welcome. Today we are discussing the theory of multiple intelligence propagated by Howard Gardner. It is very helpful to your psychology paper. Howard Gardner was born in Scranton, Pennsylvania in July 11, 1943. He is an American cognitive psychologist and author, best known for his theory of multiple intelligence. Gardner took doctoral degree in developmental psychology in 1971 from Harvard University. Gardner and others promoted efforts to understand diverse student capacities and emphasized the need for personalized educational environments, improved interdisciplinary circular programs, and the use of performance-based assessments. Gardner initially presented the theory of multiple intelligences with a list of seven intelligences in his book Frames of Mind in 1983. In the seven intelligences, the first two have been typically valued in schools. The next three are usually associated with the arts, and the final two are what's called personal intelligences. But subsequently, he refined and extended it to nine intelligences within his book Intelligence Reframed in 1999. IQ tests seemed to view people through a peephole darkly, but Gardner offered a larger vision of human potential. Then we are going to the details of multiple intelligences. Linguistic intelligence involves sensitivity to spoken and written language, the ability to learn languages, and the capacity to use languages to accomplish certain goals. It includes the ability to effectively use language to express oneself rhetorically or poetically, and language as a means to remember information. Logical mathematical intelligence consists of the capacity to analyze problems logically, carry out mathematical operations, and investigate issues scientifically. This intelligence is most often associated with scientific and mathematical thinking. Musical intelligence involves skill in the performance, composition, and appreciation of musical patterns. It encompasses the capacity to recognize and compose musical pitches, tones, and rhythms. Bodily kinesthetic intelligence entails the potential of using one's whole body or parts of the body to solve problems. It is the ability to use mental abilities to coordinate bodily movements. Spatial intelligence involves the potential to recognize and use the patterns of wide space and more confined areas. Lohmann defined it as the ability to generate, retain, retrieve, and transform well-structured visual images. Interpersonal intelligence is concerned with the capacity to understand the intentions, motivations, and desires of other people. It allows people to work effectively with others. Intrapersonal intelligence entails the capacity to understand oneself, to appreciate one's feelings, fears, and motivations. It involves having an effective working model of ourselves and to be able to use such information to regulate our lives. Naturalist intelligence enables human beings to recognize, categorize, and draw upon certain features of the environment. People with naturalist intelligence have a sensitivity to and appreciation for nature. The naturalist intelligence focuses on how people relate to their natural surroundings. Naturalists have a special ability to grow plants, vegetables, and fruit. Existential intelligence involves an individual's ability to use collective values and intuition to understand others and the world around them. It is the ability to be sensitive to or have the capacity for conceptualizing or tackling deeper or larger questions about human existence. People with existential intelligence are abstract philosophical thinkers. They have the ability to use metacognition to explore the unknown. Students, let's conclude. Following are the key points in multiple intelligence theory. Everyone has all 9 intelligences. Most can develop all 9 to competence. Intelligences usually work together. Also, there are many ways to be intelligent in each category. Thank you.